Vice President Joe Biden says the United States and Turkey are committed to defeat militants from the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria, or ISIS, in Syria. The vice president is in neighboring Turkey this weekend for meetings with Turkey's prime minister and president. Biden said the allies are prepared to increase military supplies to forces in Syria aligned against ISIS. Russia is also increasing its military presence in Syria, mainly in support of President Bashar al-Assad. United Nations brokered peace talks between Assad and his opponents resume next week in Geneva. Today, 45 opposition groups issued a statement saying they support a political process, but the biggest players are at odds. New York Times reporter Anne Barnard is covering the Syrian conflict. She joins me now by Skype from Beirut. And Anne, why are the United States and Russia signaling through their behavior that they're not necessarily confident, let's say, in a political end to this?
Well, there isn't much reason to be optimistic right now. I mean, nothing fundamental has changed in the opposition, diametrically opposed positions of the Syrian government and its Syrian insurgent opponents since Geneva two years ago. There's still a disagreement about whether President Assad needs to leave before a political transition begins. There's definitely been some changes on the ground, but there's still, no sign that all the warring parties believe that they can gain more through a peace settlement than they can by continuing to fight. So I think there's reason to believe that the fight will continue. And at the same time, you have an entire piece of this multi-sided war that's not really affected by these peace talks because it's with the Islamic State, which is not involved or invited to the talks.
Now, you wrote in one of your pieces and from your reporting that the United States and Russia have a quote, fundamental disagreement about how to move forward. What's at the heart of that disagreement?
Yeah, you can't get much more fundamental than this disagreement over how to defeat ISIS. In other words, the United States has long said that the rise of ISIS is largely because of President Bashar al-Assad's crackdown on his first peaceful and then armed opponents, and that is what has opened the space for this radically extremist group to gain a foothold. Whereas Russia has long said that they believe pretty much all of the forces fighting President Assad by force are terrorists, as he says, and they don't make much distinction between the Islamic State and the other spectrum of insurgent groups that range from nationalist rebels to Jabhat al-Nusra, which is the al-Qaeda's branch in Syria. The United States sees a meaningful spectrum, whereas Russia basically sees them all as terrorists and is attacking the other insurgents, in fact, much more than it's attacking ISIS in its airstrikes.
With a common enemy like ISIS, why isn't that enough to bring on some sort of collaboration?
Well, this is a great question. I mean, all of the parties going from Iran to Russia to the Syrian government to even the Qaeda-linked insurgents to other insurgents to the United States, they all profess to be against ISIS. But the issue is that the enmities between and among those groups supposedly arrayed against ISIS are so strong that they're not able to unite against it.
Anne Barnard from the New York Times, thank you so much for sharing your reporting.
Thank you.